What's up, guys? Double tap to flip camera. I'm using Periscope. First time using Periscope ever. I usually use YouTube Live, and it's been a terrible, what's up, Husky Size? I've been using Woody Nash. What's up, guys? Man, there's a lot of cool people joining this thing. So usually I don't use Periscope. I usually use YouTube Live, and it's a terrible experience. It's unfortunate, but yeah, like, people joining and people commenting, you lose all of this. And when you do Periscope, the comments and the people joining, it's all in here. So when you do a YouTube Live and I publish it to my YouTube channel, it's like crazy, because when anyone who didn't tune into it live watches it, they have no idea like who you're interacting with and what you're doing. So I think I'm gonna start trying to do Periscope Lives whenever I do a live video, and I'll just publish it to my YouTube channel. If you have no idea who I am, I'm Nathan Cotney, and usually I do these videos on YouTube. I've got a YouTube channel. Just check out Nathan Cotney on YouTube. It's just like youtube.com/NathanCotney. I publish a video every single day about business and marketing and just getting through life. I usually try to do an edited video about my day. When I can't, I try to put live videos out there. You know, just a quick thing, usually answering a question, sharing a story, you know, a challenge I'm going through. So if you guys have any questions, please, I mean, this is all live, please ask away. I'll answer anything you want about running a business. Again, to introduce myself a little bit more for people who are new here, I'm the CEO of a company called HiRise. It's just a very simple CRM application. We spun it off of Basecamp a few years ago. They used to be called 30 Cent Signals. They spun off and wanted to focus on Basecamp, so they spun off HiRise. And yeah, we're a team of 7 people. Just, you know, our struggles are just like any other kind of startup, really. We took over this company from scratch, built a team from scratch. Hey, thanks for building Draftin. Yeah, of course. Draft, I came from Draft to do HiRise. I still run Draft. I still keep Draft updated. I use Draft all day long, every single day. So Draft is really important to me too. I'm glad you got a lot of use out of it. That's awesome to hear. And so the topic I wanted to cover today was Martha Quintana. I hope I'm getting her last name right. But Martha has been a huge fan of my YouTube channel, big supporter. So huge shout out to Martha. When I upload this video, I'll definitely link up her channel and her question. That's awesome. Thanks for being a Draft subscriber. That's awesome to hear. Thank you. Martha asked, though, like, where do I find time to make these vlogs? Where do I find time to edit? How much time do I spend on them? When do I edit these things? When do I create them? She even asked me about workflow. You know, she found herself spending a lot of time taking a lot of footage, and then she's got all this footage of her day, and it takes her so much time to edit this stuff. So it's a really multifaceted question, and I think I'm going to publish at least a couple videos on this topic. But I think the primary thing I want to answer here in this Periscope video is just the fact that it is so important to me to produce these videos. I remember before Draft, I've done Y Combinator a couple times back in 2006 and then in 2011. And I remember I had like no audience to speak of, right? Like when we launched Inkling back in 2005, actually, you know, we got it started in 2005. We didn't launch until the beginning of 2006. It was painful. We had, you know, no customers. We also didn't have any fans, and we sent it to a few friends. And I mean, obviously, things like Twitter and Facebook weren't quite the things they are today, but still, we didn't have any email, newsletter, fans. We didn't have a blog. And so the experiences of going through Inkling, and then later on in 2011 again, I had no audience. Like, we really, like, you know, put building an audience as a low priority. Instead, we were so focused on like audience, you know, building our product, building new features. And I think it was the wrong choice in a lot of ways. We should have moved up in priority, building an audience and reaching out to people. And, you know, when I did that startup in 2011 again, we had very few people to kind of reach out to and kind of show them what we were doing. And so when that startup in 2011, it failed, it completely bombed. We were doing Advergaming and we really didn't find enough customers, and the sell process was so long. We wanted to do another project, but again, we had no audience to launch another project to. It was very tough to get traction for the stuff we were working on. So I now work very much backwards. I prioritize building an audience and doing things like marketing and making these videos and writing the top thing that I do in my career. So above making things, above building another feature. So, I mean, I still love making things. I'm still very, I think, pretty good at it. I've been doing it a number of years, but this is my priority. And so I find a lot of time now to do these things because a lot of that time now has come from other things that I do enjoy doing very much, like building products. And so I do find a lot of, you know, a lot of extra time that I think a lot of people, well, oh, you know, I'll do my job and I'll make stuff and then maybe at night I'll get a little, you know, an hour here to do this. That's not what I do. I spend hours editing this stuff, hours making these videos. When I don't have the time, I do live videos, right? I do hopefully more of these Periscopes, but I do YouTube Lives. I upload myself talking to a camera and to get a little bit better of a quality, and maybe I'll do a quick edit of that and upload it to YouTube. Maybe that only takes like 30 minutes to an hour, but something that, you know, I take a lot of time to kind of edit the story, take footage about my day, that could take 2 hours. Sometimes it takes 3 hours. Sometimes it takes even longer. And sometimes I'll cut that up over a couple days. So then, you know, if I'm missing, you know, a video today because I'm only half done with an edit, I'll do a live video. But this is also my hobby. You know, like this is one of those like, you know, I only do 4 hours of work because I don't count all that other stuff as work, Tim Ferriss kind of stuff. But it's kind of true. Like this is work, but it's also fun for me. I love making content. I love telling stories. I love meeting people online. I love, you know, editing video. And so I don't have a lot of hobbies anymore. I mean, that's not a bad or good thing. Like, I mean, I'm just in this phase of my life where this is the stuff I want to learn because I think making videos is so important to learn and get better at. So I don't play golf. We don't go out a lot. You know, I hang out with my wife and my kid, and that is the priority. I mean, that is what I spend most of my time doing. But when my kid is sleeping, I'm editing videos. My kid's sleeping right now, going to bed. I'm making videos and I'll edit more videos tonight. So that's where a lot that time comes from. I do spend quite a bit of time, more than most people are spending time making these things. But because I've prioritized it so high in my life and have kind of eliminated a lot of the other distractions and things, because I draw so much enjoyment from this. Sometimes I need breaks. You know, like today, like I'm doing a Periscope Live because I didn't have time to edit because I spent it playing video games. So like every now and then, I don't spend the time editing video. Like I do have to kind of tune out and do something like play Dishonored 2. And so that's it. Anybody got any questions while I'm here? What's up at TestySoot8? Thanks for the comment. Thanks for the love, guys. Thanks to everybody for tuning in tonight to watch us. I hope everybody's having an awesome weekend. How do you get the best feedback from your customers? By America's Guest. How do you get the best feedback from your customers? That's a good question. I don't know. How do you get the best feedback from your customers? Like, well, we did a series of these interviews, these jobs to be done interviews. If you go to my YouTube channel, there's a whole playlist about jobs to be done. And so that was the best feedback from our customers. We did this whole thing where, you know, we basically interrogated a bunch of customers where, you know, we found customers that were getting a lot of use out of HiRISE already. So we basically went for the people who already really, you know, found use out of HiRISE, and we really want to like level up their use of HiRISE. For the people who are like, you know, I'm going to go use something else. It's like, well, let's spend less time with them right now. So we focused on like really good users of HiRISE and really focus on like what they're doing with the product. So, and so to get the best feedback from customers, you have to go through a really lengthy interview process. And I'm not going to be able to repeat that whole jobs be done stuff here. Check out that playlist in the YouTube channel, but it's like an interrogation. I mean, you're sitting down a customer and you're grilling them, and you're grilling them not just about your product, but you're grilling them about like what was in their mind when they were like actually looking for a product like yours and what problems they had at work to actually solve. And so we get a lot of great feedback there, you know, from everything from the vocabulary of what they call things in their life that HiRISE fits into, to what kind of gaps are in HiRISE that they still need to fit. So look at jobs to be done stuff. That was the best way to get feedback for us. But I'm also a big believer in work on stuff that you understand very well, that you don't have to depend on a lot of customer feedback. used to work on products like Inkling. For my so many previous companies I've worked on, it's all about we struggled because it was like we depended so much on customer feedback. Whereas if we had just worked on stuff that we understood very deeply because we knew the domain very well, we wouldn't have had to rely on customer feedback as much. Like HiRise is a good example. We spend so much effort on this product, but we know it so well because we use it all day long. And I've been using HiRise since it launched, so I know the product very well. And so I know the domain. I know the gaps in the product because, like, I know this space very well myself. It's a wonderful thing to kind of know this stuff rather than have to keep asking customers for feedback to have, like, a clue of what your roadmap, you know, should have on it. All right. Guys, I hope you are having an awesome day, an awesome night. Enjoy the rest of your weekends. Thank you so much for tuning in and watching and hanging out with me. And I will see you again tomorrow. And I'll do this Periscope thing again. Yeah, interrogation. Yeah, exactly. Ryan Singer brought up the word interrogation, and it is very much like that concept. So all credit to Ryan Singer. He works at Basecamp for kind of – he's a big proponent of Jobs Be Done, and he's a very much an expert above me in this domain. Pay attention to Ryan Singer and what he talks about on this topic. So guys, later. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye, everybody. And now I got to figure out how to even turn this thing off. But I think I'm going to do more Periscopes. This was a fun interaction with y'all. Thank you.